bid for $10,000 going once, $10,000 going twice. Sold! The exquisite mirror goes to the lovely lady in lavender. Here is your key, madam.
This mirror once belonged to Albert Mort himself. Oh, I cannot wait to behold it. What? What is this? They make it sound so easy, but handling ominous objects can be dangerous. But it's nothing we can't handle, though. Right, Mr. Jenkins? For a passenger pigeon, perhaps? So, what news do you bring? Oh, a new job. This one sounds intriguing. I see you're keeping yourself busy, Mr. Jenkins. Carry on. Chasing him. I hope I'm not too late. from that mirror, it's either after that boy, or it's got a serious problem with stairs. Butler didn't do it. If a mirror breaks you, is that bad luck? What do you want with this family? The silent type, eh?
Thank goodness! It's got my jacket! Please help me take it off! I thought I was finished. Young lady, I owe you my life. But what are you doing here?
Didn't you hire me? I'm Leah Gofford, a detective specializing in ominous objects. Can you tell me anything about these mirrors? Or are they simply obsessed with fine jackets?
It wasn't I who wrote you. Perhaps Madam sent for you? I'm afraid I know little about all this, though it started shortly after Madame purchased a mirror last Sunday at an auction. I was watching young Master Patrick today when the mirrors attacked! Please, you must help me find him! I'll go for help, Miss Leah. Please, get Patrick out of here.
Patrick's clearly distrustful, but I can't blame him. Hopefully, I can make him see that I'm a friend. Patrick, your butler Edward asked me to come here and help you. I'll take care of them. Okay, these are the facts. The first family who owned the mirror died under mysterious circumstances. The mirror was then bought by a wealthy merchant family who also disappeared. The mirror went missing for a long time after that, but it was eventually found at the site of a decisive battle. After the war, the State Museum took the mirror, and the museum building was the only one completely destroyed in the earthquake.
this happening?
It's all right. You're safe now. Are you hurt?
My knee hurts.
I'll find you a bandage, buddy. Just wait here and take care of your teddy, all right?
Here, you should take this. It might help.
Never was there a happier couple than Bob and Lilith Armstrong. Their wedding was magnificent. Lilith came from a wealthy family, so they purchased a grand manor. Shortly after, she gave birth to a son, whom they named Patrick. Bob was a Navy man, went to sea to fulfill his duties. Unfortunately, his ship was lost at sea. Widowed at a young age, Lilith raised Patrick alone. She began to collect antiques as a way to reminisce on happier times.
Living statue! Oh, thankfully, it's a lousy shot. I'd love to throw something at you. We'll see how you like it.
Thank you.
What was Patrick drawing? So, Lilith got an antique mirror. And she got pulled inside of it? Uh-oh. It looks like Patrick is in danger, too. All right, Patrick. Let's bandage your... Patrick, I've got to figure out where it went. Are you Lilith? Lilith Armstrong? I'm Leia Gofford. You sent for me.
Yes, please. You must stop that horrible mirror. It's all my fault.
Don't worry. I'll find a way to get you out. Just tell me where I can find this mirror.
Thank you.